Morning children, let's continue our lesson and this is the last part of the lesson that we are doing, chapter 2, Nelson Mandela. In this, we have learned that he talks about the oppression policy that scared many people and Mandela also talks about the negative impact that this kind of policy had, the atrocities he talks about. But he also says that many courageous men were there along with him who stood up and raised their voice against the political system that was prevalent in South Africa in those times. We will begin our lesson with a beautiful thought. Shoot for the moon. Even if you miss, you will land among the stars. So children, do not stop yourself from working hard, strive hard. You will 100% get success. Let's begin our lesson again. We are doing on page number 22, first para, from I was not born with a hunger to be free. Children, here the narrator Mandela says that he did not have the plan to stand against the apartheid system early in his life. He lived his childhood like any normal child in South Africa. He only had to follow the rules set up by his father or the customs of his tribe. As soon as he grew up and began to learn the facts as to how people of color are treated, he decided to stand against it. He had this urge for freedom from inside earlier, but just for himself, and later for having a basic life, not just for himself but for everyone. Earlier he gives an example that he wanted freedom for staying out at night, etc. In Johannesburg, they had to struggle for having a peaceful marriage, family, and basic amenities which everyone has access to where law and order exist. When Mandela found that not only he but the others also there in his country were in chains, they could not enjoy freedom, he decided to do something about it. Nelson Mandela joined the African National Congress, ANC, when he realized it is not only him whose basic rights were snatched away, but of all those who looked like him. He had this fire inside him to free his people from the injustice. As he says in the same paragraph that, "I am no more virtuous or self-sacrificing than the next man." This was the realization. But I found that I could not even enjoy the poor and limited freedoms I was allowed when I knew my people were not free. "Freedom is indivisible," he says. "The chains on any one of my people were the chains on all of them." So as soon as this realization came, he wanted to do something about it. So he says further that it was this fire that changed Mandela completely as a man, from being scared to brave, a lawyer to the one breaking the law, a family man to a man without a home, and a lively man into being a monk. So he was a completely different Mandela now. Completely different man now. It was a knowledge that he and his people have restricted freedom that made him into a selfless man as opposed to before. According to him, freedom cannot be divided. As he said, indivisible it is. Snatching it away from some was equivalent to taking it away from everyone. And that meant taking it away from him. So he was against the oppressor also and being oppressed also. ही सेज आई न्यू दैट द ऑप्रेसर मस्ट बी लिबरेटेड जस्ट एज श्योरली एज द ऑप्रेस्ड बिकॉज अ मैन हु टेक्स अवे अनादर्स मैंस फ्रीडम इज अ प्रिजनर ऑफ हेट्रेड ही इज लॉक्ड बिहाइंड द बार्स ऑफ प्रेजुडाइज एंड नैरो माइंडेडनेस. प्रेजुडाइज इज प्री ओपिनियन formed and here pre-opinion was strong dislike without any good reason. So here the last line that is we have discussed before also the message of this lesson, the oppressed and the oppressor alike are robbed of their humanity. With this children we complete this lesson. This is very very important and I hope you have understood it.